Hello. Early by like t 10 seconds. Hello, Farrell. Hello, Marty. Hello, Sugar. Hello, Ray. 15 seconds. Ooh, damn. Hey, Percy. Hello, Alexo. Early is still early.
Has anyone ever told you you have stunning cheekbones?
Once or twice, I guess. I tend to try to start earlier on my times. Whenever I'm working, it's a hit or miss whether I do or not. Just in running and getting food and whatnot. And then, on most other evenings, I'm bored as shit. Hey, Dandy! So I'll typically try to start earlier, if only just to keep myself occupied. To be like, you know? Because there have been times when I've started, like, an hour or two early going, I'm bored. I'm going now. But I was also talking to mom in the last like half hour, so it's taken up the last half hour that I didn't want to wait. Accidentally waited. Good for me. Hit the table. Does this early also provide 10 lates for the group if you're the only one here? You know? I don't know about that math, Ray. But I like the idea of it. I started saying howdy unironically. Howdy's a cute greeting, though. Howdy's good. Howdy is for cowpokes alike, and people will find it charming. People will also go, "What the fuck are you doing, dude?" But just don't surround yourself with those people. People here will be like, howdy, hell yeah. But then again, I don't say howdy as a greeting when shit happens and I am like overwhelmed but not surprised. I go, boy howdy. So I still use howdy in conversational ways, just not in greeting. 10 lates, but only for Wednesdays to balance it out. There we go. Now, Ray, we're working up like a whole economy of early late here. Hey, cheer! Hey, Rebel! So, how is everyone doing on this evening of times? How is y'all? That's driving. Got more Mexican food. Fuck yeah, Alexa. We love a pattern. You should sleep, chair. Sleepy for no reason. Oh, bish, me too. I had my traditional, it's 6:30 and I can't keep my eyes open anymore. Hour and a half nap in my computer chair this evening again for like the 17th evening in a row. So we. So many times. Also, Gotham quote hit me in season five. It just goes, you're pregnant! Whenever he's like, you're pregnant! She's pregnant. Or it's the verse of that. She's like, how could you possibly know? And I just goes, you're glowing, as though it's fucking obvious. Fucking love that. And fucking clocks it. A free is almost over, so I'll have work tomorrow. Fuck. Can the man in charge of Texas actually fucking learn how to be in charge of Texas? Like, what the fuck? Feeding my feelings with ice cream! Oh! Hell yeah, rebel! There was a very short, I mean, in that, it's a short line because it's one word, delivery that I really liked. Whenever I was doing my Oswald portrait and I was trying to find a new picture for the middle because the original one I picked I didn't super like, I needed a larger quality and I just could not get it with the original image that I had without blowing it completely out of proportion and then losing all of my detail. And, so I was trying to look up a couple different scenes that I liked through YouTube and found the scene with the picture that I used with him tarred and feathered and going to Ed to be like, I gotta tell you, buddy, like, Arkham changed me and I'm on a new path and, like, the path that you're on, it's gonna hurt you, friend. And I love how Ed's got a hand on the hip and the other hand resting on, like, bed frame. And he's sitting there looking at him and he's like, cool. And it's just this little mouth shift being like, mm-hmm. Yep. Like, cool. And it's just so well done. I just started laughing. There's no other reason than hyperfixation to think this is funny, but I just really like the delivery of it. Professor of a doctor's? Yeah. Know what that's like. I'm tired of them not listening fully. I've been thinking about it a lot because I'm experiencing symptoms. Ray, I'm sorry. A lot of those people just do not fucking listen. And we've partially had this conversation on, like, Twitter replies, and I've had this conversation on stream I don't know how many times, of having that problem with my hand. And being like, well, it doesn't fucking work, so something is wrong. And people going, but we can't directly see what it is. But it doesn't fucking work! Something's wrong! And it taking, I mean, years in total. But take mom shaking down a surgeon she worked with before someone actually looked seriously. And then, even when they were looking seriously, they didn't entirely see anything, but at least then they're like, well, we're not really seeing anything, but for sure, your shit's not working. And I'm like, fucking yeah! That's what I've been trying to fucking tell people for, like, 2 to 3 years. Yeah! No shit! And then being like, well, here's the best case scenario, here's the worst case scenario, but literally until we open up your hand, we don't know. We got guesses. Best case scenario, you come out with stitches. Worst case scenario, you come out with pins, and then we'll have to kind of redo a surgery to remove them, and then recovery time again after that. Could go either way, and I'm like, I don't fucking care. I just want my hand. I kind of need it. Especially, it's my dominant one. I am legible with my left hand, and I'm very capable with my left hand. But the comfort of the right is nice, and just having the functionality of both of your hands at the same time is really convenient somehow, some way, for some reason. Yeah, so we went into the surgery being like, we don't know how you'll come out, but you'll come out with something. It's like, I don't fucking care. Just make it work. And they got in there and they found multiple problems that apparently could not be seen between like the tearing and the loose tendon and the tears in the loose tendon and the inflammation that they removed. And it's like, oh, but I was told nothing was wrong, that it was a little bit of osteoarthritis, even though all my symptoms were exactly the opposite. Rad. Okay. Or maybe I know my body and I know that shit's fucking wrong and maybe listen to me? That'd be fucking neato. And with an Uno reverse, now it's their hand injury. On a surgeon? Ooh, eat dick. It doesn't really get supposed to, something is wrong. But what do I know? Not like I live in this body and know my problems. Yep, there's a lot of like, well, you're pr and you give it to them, they see so many people, and a number of people, yes, are whining about nothing. But there's also a great number of people who are in like legitimate pain and are in inconvenient places in life because of pain or restriction of movement or some sort of internal bodily suffering, something. And it's like, don't tell me it's fucking arthritis. It's not fucking arthritis. How am I getting arthritis on just this one side of my fucking wrist? And nowhere else. Like, I'm an artist. You think it would be in my fingers? My fingers feel stiff, but it's not my joints that hurt. It's just my fingers feel lethargic to move because all of it is happening down here. Oh, and look at my scar kind of catching the light. Turn it up, turn it on again. Just reset the hand. The fuck's your problem? Have you checked up the data drives for your hand? Are the drives updated? Really nice to be able to use hands without them hurting or not wanting them to do the things, or Mike is especially without them fucking shaking all the time. None of the treatments have helped, but I don't think the doctor is going to believe me when I go back. My hands are just awful between the problems and the fact they have bel eczema. And the hands dermatologist also doesn't take serious, which is great. Fuck. God damn. Thanks, medical profession. Sammy, joints don't hurt. My fingers feel stiff and lethargic. Ray, the more we have in common with our hands, the more I want to shake someone down to also look at your tendons. Although my hands did not shake all that often unless they were tired, which usually happened by the afternoon to the evening, where I wouldn't have like a shake. But if I tried holding anything in my hand, it would kind of start to just tremble real lightly because it couldn't support the weight. Doing this was better because I have equal support from the other side, but I couldn't hold anything like this because that being the weak spot, it just folded and couldn't support itself. Could it be an essential tremor? Well, you know. But yeah, it was just my fingers would feel, and the fingers themselves felt stiff and lethargic, and they would swell, and they would just be tired all the time. And I would have a similar tiredness. And I don't want to call it a pain, because it wasn't painful, but it was almost like a tenderness. Like, and I would often describe it as your muscles after you've been to the gym, where they're sore, but they're not really in, like, a true hurting pain. They're sore because they're tired. They're sore and they're tender because they are just fucking shot. So there was finding a lot of very particular words in there, but because it wasn't real pain, and it's like, well, no, the pain is just not here. But here, it's excruciating, but thank you. That's great. Yeah. Getting people to figure out hand shit is a fucking uphill battle. No one seems to take it seriously, but it's like, girl, how would you feel if you didn't have one of your hands? They're a little bit essential to everyday life. It's a little bit debilitating to not have the functionality of at least one of your fucking hands. Kind of a fucking bummer when you slept wrong and wake up and your hand is in terrible pain. And if I fell asleep wrong and I wake up in pain, that's it. My hand is already done for the day and I just became conscious. It could have been okay when I went to sleep, but somewhere in my sleep, it got twisted or bent or even just like dangled off the bed for too long. And my hand would decide that that was enough. And I would wake up and I would have no strength or helpful usage of my hand. It's like, oh, cool. Just woke up and it's at like 20%. Rad. And I still have to go to fucking work, where I lift like half of my fucking body weight. Neato. And always trying to find jobs, because I try to be careful of that in general. But like, 2/3 of jobs are like, be able to lift at least 50 pounds. I'm like, girl, I am small. That is like 40% of my fucking body weight. I think it was like 40, 45 or something at the time. But that's like almost half of my body weight. I ain't going to the fucking gym. You expect everyone in this job just be able to lift 50 pounds and consistently lift it once. Absolutely no problem. But you have to be able to lift that 50 pounds, like, throughout the fucking day. I was like, girl, that's what a fucking dolly is for. Why do I have to be able to carry 50 pounds all day? Don't we have fucking technology? Didn't we invent the goddamn wheel? Don't nobody got a fucking cart somewhere? Go fuck yourself, I have to be able to lift 50 pounds all day. Fuck off. And it's just like, I just can't apply to jobs where it's like strenuous lifting. Must be able to carry the entire damn store on your shoulders for multiple hours. No bitching. Hold it there. Like, oh, cool. I'm glad every job wants me to be fucking Atlas. Also, hey, soul. And it's like, it's so fucking, but it's like, It just makes you angry. It's fine. If you're a larger man, or a larger woman, or a larger person, or someone who do be going to the gym. Great if you're those kind of people. If you are small man, if you are small woman, if you are small person, and or, God forbid you have both, some sort of disability or like bodily, trying to think of another way that's not disability, but just step under. Say, just like a continuous bodily ailment. How tall is you? How tall is me? Like 5'7". It's just, God forbid, if you're small and something wrong with you, because then you're just fucked. Can you carry 50 pounds, carry the team on my back, and push through barriers? But it really is, like, there's a ton of jobs that I would have liked to apply for anytime I've been unemployed, but it's always, you need to be able to do strenuous work all day. You need to be able to lift 50 pounds all day, or it's incredibly hard on the hands to do. And it's like, cool, that gets rid of like 85% of my options because I can't do any of them for any amount of like, I could do it well for one day, and the next day, I'll be done. But no, you'll have to go to work the next day. And then I am like, chronic is the word, maybe? Yeah, chronic ailment would be a combination of words I could use there. Excellent. Thank you, JJ. In this argument, at the old job that is required to lift 125 pounds and assisted, someone can go 125 kiss my ass. No. Too many jobs at the 50 pounds deals a copy paste to fill it requirements. Also. Just like, because of being in pastry, there are a lot of my positions are either strenuous on the hands, are long-term laborious through the day, and or I do need to be able to lift 50 pounds. You get a fucking 20 kg bag of flour coming in. Guess what? You hauling that shit back to the kitchen. Which isn't quite 50, but... Must be able to stand for long periods of time is another one? Yeah! The fucking must be able to stand for long periods of time. My back isn't great, but, like, I can fake it, and if I'm moving, it's better. So a little bit of a dancing, a little wibbling wobbling, being able to at least pace in a small space, usually I can fake it through to the end of the day and it's fine. But anyone with like chronic back problems, hip, knee, ankle, whatever, fucked. Like, and that's a lot of retail shopping, like, types. No. Walk 15 miles with this bag that weighs 60 pounds while carrying another 30 pounds in equipment. Absolutely not. Are they 50 pound bags? They're not perfectly 50-pound bags. They are 20 kg bags. So the 20 times 2.2. Do not miss being on my feet for 8 hours because of lifting 50 pounds of chicken back and forth regularly. Yeah, no, see? Bad! Fucking AIs are stealing our art, but we can't have fucking conveyor systems or better delivery systems for people. We can't have, like, better mats or break shifts or whatever to... Why are we, A, not getting fucking paid enough so that we can live? Because I'm not gonna be able to move out. Why would I move out? And we've had this conversation before as well. Why would I move out and live in, like, poverty by myself when I can be at home and get pretty pictures on me and travel and get to do the things that give me at least some fucking joy? But, like, we're not getting paid enough to live. Jobs are inaccessible for such a large number of people. We, like, you have to find a really nice manager in order to kind of semi take care of you. But, like, shit's fucking wild. And something that'll save me this summer.
Has anyone ever told you you have stunning cheekbones?
Once or twice, I guess. Hello, King! Something that'll save me this summer is the fact that I am still assistant manager at work means I am the second last person who needs to scoop ice cream. Hey, Cham! I don't know how to shorten your username. So if you like anything different, Chamnum, let me know. Lumberjack job certainly sucked, carrying 50-pound packs, 12-pound saws, 5 miles to and from. Fuck. Just call me Jay. Will do, Jay. I will do my best to remember it until a pattern is formed and then it sticks with me. What's this about scooping ice cream? I work at an ice cream place! But we don't got no soft serve. We got the shit you gotta scoop. I used to do that. Yeah! Or scream. Actually, I used to have... Actually, I think my first job was a dairy bar. My first, like, job that I had on my own. I think it was. And then, now here I am again. Back to the ice creams, though not at just a dairy bar. Now it's more like, for lack of a better term, more of like an ice cream restaurant, but that makes it sound way fancier than it is, but it's definitely more than a dairy bar. It's that, like, in between. Attached to the coffee shop I worked at, and I was the only one good at making milkshakes. Ah, damn! Someone has to be the cone king, and that is Skulls. I am the cone king! Literally no one at that store makes cones as good as me! I am the cone man! I make incredible waffle cones, and they're so fucking consistent! And I make, like, 1,500 of them, and they're all very close to being similar to each other in, like, color, in shape, in size. They all stack super clean and super nicely. And I maybe throw out one or two in the entire batch. I am incredible at making cones. Oh, we'll see you then, sugar. Respect the cone master. Respect the fucking cone master. 8,500 more to be an expert. Well, it was 1,500 in a day. And I was making cones at least 3 times a week for like 3 to 4 months. And that's just for summertime. That doesn't include fall, winter, and spring when we drop down to like a whole lot less. Then it's like making, we'll say closer to, it's like 120 for one rack. So like 360 cones. And yeah, it'd be like 360 if we're doing just like a bucket or two. And to do math here. Wait a second. Every time I open my clock instead of my calculator, and I don't know how I haven't learned by now. So there's like 120 and one rack. We do about 3 racks with 2 buckets. No, around like 1,500 if we're doing the full, if we're doing the full amount. And that is just me on 3 waffle grills for like somewhere between 5 to 6.5 hours of just making cones to pump that many out and be able to clean the grills before the end of my shift. And you gotta be, if you're on time and you're plowing away and you don't have to stop for anything, especially when Sarah's with me. Ed opens calculator instead of the clock ruler. Finally, a clock I can read. Especially when Sarah's working with me, because I don't have to stop if Sarah's there. Normally, it would be make so many racks of cones, stop, turn around, bucket the ones that have been cooling, because they need like 20 minutes to do that before we can bucket them, label them, weigh them, put them away. But if Sarah's ever working, and if one of the other girls, Camille, is there, although Camille's not quite as on the ball as Sarah is, but Sarah's my wife, so I can't fault Camille for anything like that. Sarah and I just, Alexa, add a H on the end of that, Sarah, and then you got it. Sarah and I just click. So I'll be going, making. I got all my cones and I start hitting a certain amount, so I start slowing down a little so that we can start packing things away. And Sarah just slides right in behind me and starts putting, thank you, Alexa, starts packing everything away for me. And I'm like, God bless, thank you, I love you. And she's like, yeah, I know, it's okay. I love you too. And I'm like, fuck yeah. I also told Emma and Sarah about the love for them on this channel and of the clip that is for them. And both of them are like, ah. Bless the work wife. Bless up my work wife. Bless up my work wife. Bless up my work girlfriend. Bless up them both because they take fucking care of me and keep me as a solid person. Hot ice cream. Now I don't have any. I go to work tomorrow. To do a shift. And my blueberry ice cream should still be there. So I'm thinking about getting a half liter of that tomorrow and bringing it home as like a treat to me. Solid skulls is a good thing over a melted one. Ooh! A number of people at work have seen me melted, crying out back. This is just too much pressure. And it's like, but it's like an ice cream place. And it's like, yeah, one of the most visited locations in the summertime at a place, like in a province that is literally just a tourist trap. Triple, especially in the summertime, where it is a line from open until close. Heavy's the crown of the Cone King. And it is thousands of people go through that fucking door, and it is wild. And then you've got the theater literally across the street. So every time they let out a show, everyone goes over to the ice cream shop across the street. And they especially love doing that at night. And that's always great. 15 minutes to close when, like, a couple hundred people decide they all want ice cream right the fuck then and line up right before close, and you go, great, all right, we'll plow through then. Do you have a hell of a nice province? Never been, but everyone I talk to insists to make a trip up there eventually. Yeah. It's certainly nice. It's nice to see. As long as you visit in like the summertime, there's like nothing to fucking do the other three seasons of the year. They try. Right now, now that it's February, I'm gonna be going back to full time because there's a lot of shit happening. We've got like three different hockey tournaments happening over the next like month, and the Canada Games are being hosted here, so we have all of that. And there is the, what is it, the Ice Festival is happening right now too. There's many things. And fuck hockey kids, most of them. Oh my god, entitlement, holy shit. Some not so bad. I find, like, oddly enough, the 15 to 16-year-old boys, at least whenever I'm at the counter, not too bad. They shut the fuck up, they get quiet, and they tell me what they want. They're like, yeah, can I get, like a double scoop of that and that? Like, yes, you absolutely may. And then the whole spiel on the end of that. And you get them what they want, and you take them to the cash, and they just tap their cart, and then they leave. And I'm like, abs, thank you, sir. Get the fuck out. But thank you for being kind to me. Any soccer teams show up consistently? Sometimes in the summer, you'll get a few of the soccer teams. Not too many. I feel like a lot of the sports kids we see are gymnastics, dance, hockey, and ringette. Not many other sports teams come in around the same time. It'll be like one kid who happens to play sports and is wearing their jacket with like a friend or two, or maybe a parent, but. Still a great shirt. It is a great shirt. I love my ruler shirt. I'll break it in. They want to get their ice cream and leave without problems, and I respect them for it, right? Some of the other people have problems with the teen guys, but I don't normally get any issues. One of my favorite anticipations when scones list normal things, and the last item on the list is something I haven't heard of before. What was the last thing I listed? Was it ringette? Yeah. So if you've not heard of ringette before, Alexo, think of a whole ton of girls, or at least femmes, take a hockey stick and break the blade off of the end so it's just a stick, and then replace the puck with a ring. Think of like a Sonic Golden ring, but just make it like, I'm assuming it's puck material, but I don't know. And that ringette is just hockey, but just a stick, and the puck is larger but hollow in the middle. Fantastic shirt that I might have bought in purple just because it's a stupider, realer shirt, and like really makes me giggle, and I have a fixation to wear it. Ray, you have it too. More complicated field hockey. Yeah, kinda. Ringette is lacrosse with hockey rules. Yes. Hockey would make it Sonic. So yeah, ringette. There ain't many femmes in hockey, especially around here. It's the teams are almost, if not completely, solidly boys. So ringette is kind of the way to get girls into hockey without putting them in with the guys, because I imagine that's some sort of fucking gender problem for this 50 years in the past Christian island. So. I enjoy hearing about other places' regional things that they don't entirely realize are regional. Yeah, I really did just say ringette with my whole ass chest as though every single person knows what I'm talking about. Move to Canada where the cold is prepared for. Yes, you can, Percy. I don't know how to help you with that, but absolutely, you could. That is something you could physically accomplish over time. Street hockey, superior form of hockey, anyways. I fucking loved in elementary school where the older grades, and I think it was grade 6 to grade 8. I think we had a rotation. I don't know if it started at grade 5 or grade 6, but we were allowed to bring in hockey sticks, and we would leave them in like this big tub out in the hallway, and we'd be able to go play street hockey out in the parking lot, and they would leave us a space, and the kids would be able to go and get nets from the gym and bring them outside. So every like so many days, and I think the older kids got like 2 days of the week, something like that. And yeah, just go out and play street hockey with whoever's in your class, and it was fun. I loved it. Every recess at my school, fuck yeah, Marty. One thing I saw on my travel that made me think Skullurday. Drove through Skellington, and Vernon has a giant skeleton on Main Street that I should take a. Please do, Alexo. If you go by him again, please do. Did it with rocks. We always had balls. We had those like those bright ass orange I want to say like a hard rubber, but it was like those plastic feeling ones that you could barely bend with your fingers. Marty screaming, yes, yeah, you know what I'm talking about. We had those. That's what we played with. We got them with the nets in the gym and took them out with us. Getting put in the non-gender separated gym class my senior year was the best thing ever because the guys don't move when you charge them. Floor hockey's only fun if someone's bleeding. Hey, Jericho. Know what you're talking about, but they were always locked away when we tried to play. Boo! Fuck yeah, use rocks. Knock out some kids' teeth. Which, actually, we've gotten kids to lose teeth during street hockey before. One of the ones in particular that I remember, because it happened during one of our games, where this kid named Trevor, if I can remember what happened now, but he either tripped in general or tripped over somebody's stick and went forward into the big like dumpsters that were by the hockey nets, because one net was in front of a little hill that went up to the school, and the other net on the other side of the parking lot had the dumpsters directly behind it. So he tripped either in general or over somebody's stick and went face first into the dumpsters, and he can't remember if he knocked out both front teeth or if he broke both front teeth, but both front teeth got some bad damage, and then he ended up putting them through his lower lip chin region because it was right in that little dimple space there, and he had to go get stitches. Hockey. Veneer industry in Canada must make some coin. Oh, it's so fucking funny to look at hockey players whenever they take their teeth out, because like 75% of them are fucking missing, and then they just pop their good old veneers back in. I played street hockey either in school or neighborhood kids. I do remember a kid getting a tooth knocked out via kickball to the face. Sixth grade PE recess. Hell yeah. Why is that such a common school occurrence? I don't know, but it's a great question. But yeah, that was one of the fun things that happened. One of very, very many. And it was that same parking lot where I tore my elbow open to the bone because my friend ran into the back of me because I stopped for God knows what fucking reason. And that was also where I two-hand shoved the kid down for interrupting our skip rope game. A lot of stuff happened at that one section of parking lot. Anybody have any good, cool PE recess stories? I don't know. I mean, I definitely have stories, whether they're good or not, or it is like all up to someone's perspective. I have a lot of stories, but public school builds character. Skip rope is fucking serious. I just wanted to play skip rope with my friends, and that dumbass boy kept stopping the skip rope every time we got like three rotations in, and he'd stick his foot out, and I told him no. Like, stop. We want to play our game. Go away. And we tried again, and he did it again. And I told him, I'm warning you. Stop. We are playing our game. All we want to do is play. Man. Did it a third time. So I two-hand shoved him down to the pavement and I went, fuck off. In probably grade appropriate language, because this was in like 4 or 5 or 4 seems way too young. Maybe like 5 or 6. It was within that range of years. I don't remember anymore. It was somewhere in there. And then he fucking tattled on me, the little bitch. And I got in trouble for it. Fucker. I just wanted to fucking skip rope. And you do the apples, oranges, peaches, plums, jump right in with your birthday comes. I could never fucking jump in, because I'm August. And he was stopping it in, like, March and April, so I never fucking got a turn, so I was mad. Accidentally concussed a girl with a 1 in 100 soccer ball punch to the face. That is a very good story. When I hear dumb children being fucking terrible little assholes type thing, depends on the assholery. If it's bullying, no. I don't care about that, to be completely honest. I got enough of that for a little while until I asserted my male dominance over them. Breaking a foam-covered baseball bat over a kid with a neck brace's neck, being a piece of shit to me and throwing the pebbles on the playground just covered in at me. Fuck that neck brace kid, he had it coming. Did archery, but weirdly didn't result in as many, like, as many incidents as you'd think, but there were still some. In gym, I was at the class in revolt, wanted to play kickball. Teacher said soccer, so I convinced our class to play kickball, only using our feet. Damn. Hard to get those tosses in. Accidentally hit a bird once. Oh, great aim. Someone fucking Hunger Games their shit right there. Same idiot who decided to take a pile driver from someone, which led to him getting the neck brace. Fuck that one kid. Bitches learn about Darwinism. Maybe a bit too slow, but fuck that kid. Who here remembers the fitness grand pacer test? I think pretty much everyone would. It was even, like, an alert here at some point. And it was actually, like, it made a resurgence as a meme not too long ago. So honestly, if people didn't know the fitness grand pacer test, I'd be more surprised. We all had to do the fitness grand pacer test. Fucking sucked. But I cheated the system, because we were always graded in the, hey, Fister! The fitness grand pacer test, we were always marked in improvement. Any of y'all ever complete it? What was the level for completion? Yeah, so it was marked by improvement, and if you've made an improvement since last time, and my lungs have never liked me running too much. Like, I'm a sprinter, I am not a long-term dasher, especially when it gets faster the longer you fucking go. I want to go super fast at the start, and then just maintain a slow pace and keep going. But, yeah, I always gave up at, like, level 2 or 3. And then I just made sure to do 0.1 or 0.2 more than the last time. And technically, I have improved. And I went, no, I did this seriously one time, and I couldn't breathe afterwards. My lungs were on fire, and I was horrendously uncomfortable. So I decided very quickly after that, I'm not fucking doing the fitness grand pacer test like they want me to. I get to, like, sit on my ass for an hour and just watch these assholes run back and forth where all the sporty, competitive kids yeah. All the sporty kids took it very seriously, and I would take, like, a nap on the stage, or the kids would jump onto the stage and just throw balls at each other until the kids were knocked out, and then they would do the next. As long as I wasn't the first person out, I did not care too much, as long as I did good enough to pass. Oh, I did not care if I was the first kid out. I'd be like, yep, I'm done, bye. I'd just walk away and be like, I'm not fucking doing this. This is not my strength, and I don't need to kill myself over this, so... I love giving up so I can have a break, right? Let's see. I don't know, it just looked up like end. Final lyrics, final words. It's like. Oh, yeah, because we always called it the beep test. We never fully said fitness grand pacer test, but it always had the opening. That's a question I want. Yeah, that's great, but how many fucking stages were there? Why could you use the wrestling team as an excuse to not do the run test? Twenty-one levels, okay. I'm trying to think. I don't know if anyone ever completed it in our grade. I'm sure one or two kids have, and I just don't remember because it wasn't important. I remember kids getting to, like, 17 to 19 regularly, and by kids, I mean, like, the ultra-sporty try-hard kids would regularly get to 17 to 19. Yeah, I'm sure someone's completed it, but I both don't remember and I don't care overall. I care to contribute to the conversation, but I don't care about the test. We did it together, it was better. Oh, Ray, that's real cute. The highest I ever saw was 18, yeah. First I ever made was 8 to 10. Oh, fuck yeah, Fister. Cannot remember anyone going longer than a dozen before there was enough kids out playing a fun game that still wanted to quit and play. Yeah, we had the kids that usually lasted to the end of it were all the kids who, and I mean, made sense, played hockey in the winter and they always played soccer in the summer. So these were kids that just ran all year, all the time, and their drills are exactly the fitness grand pacer test. So them being super good at it, not a huge surprise. It just meant that we had a longer time to do fuck all. I remember dodgeball was always the game I wanted to play in gym. I love dodgeball. I was one of them dodgy kids. I couldn't aim for shit. Like, I couldn't aim the ball to get somebody out, but I could dodge like hell. And I could biff the ball to the other side of the gym like hell. And those were my two jobs. And there were often times where I was the last one on our team. And I would end up with the balls on my side. So I would just throw them back over to the kids who were still on the other team who would throw at me. Because I would be better at catching what they threw than me trying to throw at them and get them out. So it's like, no, go right ahead. Throw more. I'll fucking catch it and I'll get you out that way, because that's the only way I could do it. Really happy when I started band because I didn't have to do PE anymore. I had to do both. That's because my electives were down in high school, though, so I had to have an extra elective, and gym was one of the last things that I hadn't already gotten a credit for. I completed so much of school, but also I completed almost none of it. When running wasn't involved. Didn't hate PE, but didn't like it either. Yeah, I thought gym was fine. Then again, I was like an energy kid who did well with being able to go to PE and burn off the energy for a little bit. And again, my favorite games, like I said, dodgeball was one. Fucking loved me some badminton and volleyball, which then I went and joined the volleyball team in high school later on. Still love volleyball. I want to fucking play it again. Oh, my fucking sport, man. That's how I joined volleyball, because when I said pick a fall sport, I looked at my options and picked the sport with the least amount of running. There's no running in volleyball. It's all hardcore sprinting, which is why I liked it. Because it's like, oh, the one kind of running I'm good at. Fuck yeah, let's go. I can sprint like a motherfucker. Had to do 2 semesters of gym in high school. Made sure it came last class of the day because our locker room showers notoriously gave a ringworm and staph infections. Ah! I was libero. Rebel, what are you talking about? Like you were zero? Yeah, our high school gym had showers, but we never had time to take showers. Especially whenever I took gym, I think both in like grade 10 and grade 11, gym class was right before lunch. And bitch, I don't got time to shower. I need to get upstairs because it's like deep fried chicken burger day. And if I don't get up there like immediately, the line is down the fucking hall and they run out. I will stink in that line. I do not give a single flying fuck. I will like generously put on deodorant, but I'm going to go get my fucking chicken burger. No one can stop me. I was in 5th grade, I got out of PE because the class would be right before lunch. By then I was so ready to eat lunch, I get nauseous. Aww. Yeah, let me also flip to the other screen. Oh, fucking kill me. All the boys who thought Axe was a fucking shower. Fucking vomit. Defensive specialist in volleyball usually specializes in backline hitting and serving. Oh, okay. We just called that like zero or the switch. Gotcha. Because they always had a different color jersey, and as soon as it came to the front line, they would book it back to the bench and someone would come in for them. Gotcha, gotcha, gotcha. Okay. Yeah, they always had like a big zero on the back of their jersey. It was like, oh. I always wished I was that guy, but because I was one of the taller people, he uses in the front line also too short. Oh no. It was always like the fucking spunky short kids that were like the switch position. But no, because I was one of the taller people on the team, I was middle. Fucking loved middle. Middle was great. 50% of my job is just to stand with my arms up at the net. Fucking fantastic. Loved it. Every once in a while, a little hop, and all I have to do is gay hands and tell the girls to go fuck themselves when they're trying to spike at the net. Did a lot of tackling. Of course you did, mister. G-Reg loves sports, but do you think he ever played one? I like to think G-Reg has tried to play at least two sports and failed miserably at both of them, but walked away with like a very positive experience. Just a ray of trans sunshine. Hello. Position did you play trash talker? Who are we talking about? I mean, no one in particular. We're talking about school sports at the moment. So yeah, I fucking loved middle. Middle was great. And that's where like our one of our scenes, one of our big clips of the early days. Where I said I smacked a girl in the face with my balls before came from volleyball, which I think most people at the time, like everyone knew because I explained it, because I explained everything. Greg played t-ball as a child, and his parents were very proud of him, and he's never forgotten that feeling. It's why he loves the energy of sport. Oh, cute! Derek has definitely played. Oh, Derek absolutely has played a sport. Derek is one of those kids who played like one and a half sports every season and was good at like all of them. Cut you with what? What the fuck did he have? During the Gears of War, during the Gears of War stream. That was my favorite part of volleyball. You got to get away with just like getting your rage out and spiking the ball, and if a particular player is pissing you off, you just aim to break that bitch's nose with the ball as best you can, and it's so fucking good. And it's like, well, I don't know what you want me to do. Glass from a mirror. Did you go to gym in a movie? Did you go to gym at Euphoria High? What the fuck? I never seen that show. Yeah. Not a lot happened at school for like incidents. My fault she can't dig. Oh, Fister, that's defense. Should have done that. Love the lore for G-Reg and D-Reg. G-Reg went to all D-Reg's games and didn't know what was going on, but he cheered the hardest. G-Reg would be a really good cheerleader. He's one of those, like, Tumblr base guys. G-Reg is always the one you can count on. Why the fuck did you sniff coo? I don't know, I'm not in charge of your headphones. I don't know. I get that a lot sometimes whenever my cable's a little fucky, even if it's plugged in all the way. Some sounds will only come through on the left side, and it's like, what the fuck? Choice selection, left ear snip. You've got his arms up already, right? Because he'd be so good. Because, like, you know, you could count on G-Reg to toss somebody up and you know he's gonna catch you. Like, G-Reg has never dropped anyone. He's never dropped a single, and I don't know what that position is called, but the air girls, I'll call for lack of position. I know the tumblers and the stunters, and then I start making up things. Flyers, thank you, Rebel. Throw an occasional ASMR to keep everyone on their toes. Who's G-Reg? The whale throwing up his arms. That's G-Reg. Yeah, G-Reg's our friend. He loves sports and he doesn't understand them, but he loves them. So yeah, if we put G-Reg into cheerleading, absolutely. That's the one sport he just like he feels that T-ball appreciation again. Quiet bookish nerd who happens to know some random things about sports. Fuck yeah, Rebel. That's how we do. He's got good rhythm. Oh, so suave. On beat with his arm flaps. But for some reason is in a skirt. Nah, not for some reason. G-Reg can choose to wear the skirt just to feel a little extra pretty that day. He don't care. G-Reg doesn't feel gender. G-Reg does what G-Reg wants. I like the skirt addition though. G-Reg is all about the uniform. He's so about the uniform. It's the flow of the skirt. Loves it. G-Reg wanted to do a sport, but he was bad at all of them, so someone suggested he do cheerleading, which is like sport but less balls, and he's good at it. G-Reg would love. Oh, and with his arms? G-Reg would rock pom-poms. 959 goddamn sugar. Thank you for giving out that sub to the Trans Ray Sunshine. I kind of swooped all parts of that username around. Be so positive. Team's get an extra boost when G-Reg is cheering because he's just so happy. How can you let him down? Oh my god. I can just imagine G-Reg has cried one time at a sport game and literally everyone felt bad about it. Every single fucking person felt bad. That G-Reg cried one time. It wasn't a heavy cry. It wasn't a sob. Just a few little tears. But everyone's like, never again. We can't let this happen. For G-Reg. G-Reg can never cry. Never break G-Reg's heart. He's so pure. We take care of this boy and his twirly skirts and his positive attitude, god damn it. He's precious. G-Reg tries football and he's an amazing player, though he feels bad accidentally bowling everyone over. A t-shirt with four G-Reg on it. Hell yeah. G-Reg is our boy. Our accidental little piece of perfection. So, exactly one person was mean to him one time, and the rest of the cheer squad just made that person disappear. He'd be great on the swim team. He's literally a whale. Potentially. He doesn't like to swim, though. It is funny that it makes his flippers feel weird. Oh no! Autistic G-Reg, our champion! He's a master of floating. Same, also same. Where did Ralph go? Ralph went to a farm upstate. It's G-Reg does not have the competitive spirit. That's why he goes to sports games he doesn't understand and he cheers for both sides. He just likes people being happy, and he likes being happy with happy people. He's a sweetheart. We adore G-Reg. G-Reg has joined Kansas James and the Culver's guy in Voided History. G-Reg truly is like a character that now is fully evolved. But I was gonna say, about the swim team. Thanks, distraction. It's funny that he's both a whale lord and a Snorlax, which is like the Snorlax is an incredible swimmer. If anyone remembers those old Pokemon episodes, Snorlax is like an Olympic swimmer. But it's funny that Whale Lord just kind of like floats in the air, which could be a reason that G-Reg can't be on the swim team A because not competitive. But also, he's real buoyant on the surface of the water and he can't get his arms to do the proper movement to swim. He's a great life preserver if you ever need one. But like champion swimmer, maybe not. Yo, fucking Snorlax owns this movie. Can't wait until the next Gardic. Oh, G-Reg's coming up in Gardic Foam. There's gonna be like a G-Reg round. Why is G-Reg suddenly making me think of Baymax from Big Hero 6? Now we're getting somewhere. G-Reg loves bowling because he can just cheer whenever pins topple. Yep. Gardevoir is now just G-Reg and Culver's, man. Well, you know. Every time the Culver's man does like a company baseball game against, I don't know, the other convenience stores, G-Reg is always there for Culver's man. The stick wolves. Go get that trash, Rebel. Bring me in. Oh, absolutely. Like, G-Reg is cuddly himbo bear who just he there to help. I don't have any liquid around. I can't do that. None of the beverages in the house are ones that I want. There is Kool-Aid powder. I can make Kool-Aid. But now I'm in the middle of stream. So I can't make Kool-Aid right now. No lemonade? No, I drank it all. No blood for your enemies? Now I'm out. I don't live around my enemies. All my enemies are away. Becomes water. If only I liked water. I tried to avoid it as much as possible. Kool-Aid making stream. Just keep like extending the USB cord, bring the webcam with me downstairs. Becomes Monster Energy. I also do not drink energy drinks. 70% water. Get it. Get in there. Get that liquid. Bring us with you to make Kool-Aid. You know, I keep teasing the whole, like, becomes Pepsi. I hate to break it to you. I hate to ruin this for you, Trans Sunshine. You trying, though, and God bless. Skulls drinks pizza. If you don't chew it, it's a drink. One of D-Rex sports is golf. While everyone else is quietly clapping, D-Rex is always yelling. D-Rex always so happy to see him, but he just quietly waves back. Do you get your water from roots in the ground? Well, I don't have an interest in hydrating, which is a funny thing to kind of say, but drinking liquid bores me, so I don't like doing it. I like, if I have a liquid of any kind, if there's not a straw in the cup, I get bored with it, or I will hit a certain point and I just chug the rest of the glass because I don't want to do it anymore.
That isn't very pogger.
Gecko! Pretty much how I'm alive, I think. The Kool-Aid. So, I don't really drink many sodas. If I go out to fast food places, you'll get like a medium soda, and I will drink that much off the top. And then I throw the rest away because I don't want it. Even if it's a flavor I like, I don't drink a lot of sodas. You just don't really drink full stuff. Look! I try sometimes. Sometimes I feel dry. And sometimes the headaches start coming in. And if the headaches start popping in, I'm like, oh, dehydration headache. So then I just start gobbling down liquids until the headache goes away. And then I stop gobbling down liquids. Did we get you carrots? Oh, I had mini carrots today. Or baby carrots, whatever the fuck you want to call them. So if I ever drink sodas, it is like a 7-Up or Sprite if you're American, but I do prefer 7-Up because it's more flavorful. Every time I go to the States and I have Sprite, I'm disappointed. Lemonade gets me every time. If it's a sugary lemonade, I'm not interested in it. I want the tart lemonades with just a touch of sugar in them. Root beer. I really like root beer in general, but a lot of root beers now are going commercial, so a lot of them are made with cane sugars, so they're a lot sweeter, and they taste like a normal soda, so then again, I lose interest in them. And then I drink particular flavors of Kool-Aid or Gatorade. And that's about it. The Kool-Aid, I'll drink the the blue raspberry and the cherry. If it's not those two flavors, I don't care. The Gatorade, I always want orange. If there's no orange, I will suffer with blue or red. The yellow's okay. But honestly, if it's not orange again, my interest wanes. And I find that maybe because Gatorade is supposed to pep you up and bring you back from physicality, it's really sugary, especially I find now it's extremely sugary. So I'll get halfway through a Gatorade and I'll get bored and I'll get rid of it. So I I don't drink a lot of things. Even now, I don't know if I drank anything yesterday, and I definitely didn't drink anything today. I had the baby carrots, though. So, I don't hydrate very often. So I don't like it, and I've got a lot of things that I like, and I'm very particular with many a thing, which isn't convenient for me. But we live with it. We make do. I get all my vitamins and shit checked, and somehow I'm still alive. And somehow all of my everythings are where they should be. And honestly, I think that's a lie, but that's what the doctor tells me. So A&W locations make A&W on site, and it's really good. I don't know if you have A&W in Canada. A&W was like made in Canada. We got tons of them around here. But then again, I don't super like A&W root beer because, again, a lot of it is made with cane sugar. So it's sweeter. I don't like sweet root beers. It's typically why I really like pub root beers and little like hole in the wall barbecue places that essentially have their own root beer or root beer from local places because they'll make a more bitter and rooty root beer. Because they're not pussies trying to sell out to the mass amounts of people. And it makes me sad because I don't want sugary drinks because I'm not a sugary taste person. I don't like a lot of sweetness, and sweetness bores me really quickly. So especially like chocolate. I'm not a huge fan of chocolate. I will have like one chocolate bar a month, and even then I will eat half of it on one day and I will eat half of it on the next day, and then I'm done. I'm good. I don't want any more. I will wait till next month and I will get my next chocolate bar if I feel it. Your cactus requires very little hydrat. Exactly. You said when I had my baby carrots yesterday broke me. Ooh, a drink stand that makes her own root beer at my local Comic-Con. Ooh, I'd be intrigued. I'll always give them a chance. Rings. But yeah. Supermarkets and look at root beers to measure sugar count. So much, 40 plus grams of sugar if you have less than 15, but they use honey. Yes, it's all about the sweetness now. Everybody wants root beers to be sweet so that they can sell them to normal people who have sugar addictions with sodas. They want to be the Pepsis and the Cokes and the Mountain Dews now. Now they're really trying to like brand out, so they are just sugar slapping root beers and they're ruining them. Hate it. Very spicy considering my extreme rarity of drinking anything carbonated. Ooh, extra intrigued. Local restaurants that both make their own root beer, but I know from both knowing the owner and my sister working there that they use unholy amounts of sugar. Boo! Cowards! Yeah, so those are just fizzy water and high fructose corn syrup. High fructose corn syrup. 8 packages, and I mean like packages of sugar. 3 drops of water. Carbonation and coloring. And there you go. Soda pop. Physically cannot eat hot dog, sausages, certain brand coffee. So, yeah. Oh, just, I am a plethora. I am a list of intricacies and needs and textures, and I mean, like, tism, you get it. And if something just isn't to my taste liking, that's it. It's gone. I'll never touch it again. We like to chew our soda. But yeah, I've got a couple friends who don't eat meats, like, in general, because they don't like the texture of it or they don't like the flavor of it. So one of my friends with that, Emma, is a vegetarian because she doesn't really like the texture, she doesn't really like the taste. And it's like, damn, I mean, fair game. More meat for me. But we're having a Skullurday intro today. We are. And that's why I've learned better, and now I just put the opening game to just chatting, because I've learned. The wax candy soda bottles. Oh my god, like the carbonated soda gummies. Or it's like the wax ones where you bite the packaging open and you squirt it in. No, it's just nice every once in a while to have a Skullurday intro, and I'm feeling it. We're on conversations, but wax ones where most kids just chew the whole thing open. Bottle cap. Yeah. Okay, I gotcha, gotcha. I know what you're talking about now. Also, the fun thing, I got the Valentine's done, and I'm bringing them to the mail tomorrow morning, before I go to work. And when I tell you, I still have, like, stacks of erasers. Because the erasers that came in the package, I cut them in half with an X-Acto knife so they would fit in the envelope better, and so that I would have more options of, like, the good patterns and designs that were in there. So I've just got, like, a stack of solid colored erasers now, because I could and I can. Plus, there were rainbow ones in there. So when I tell you that my mutuals and my favorites got the gay erasers, there were 6 in the package, but with my handy-dandy knife, I had 12. So more gay erasers for people. Candy lipsticks they used to have? Are we talking like push pops that they were functional in, like, their movement, that they were like lipsticks? Or is it actual, like, lipsticks or candy that were shaped like them? Predecessor to push pop. Oh, okay. Yeah. Cutting things to make more things is smart. A, cutting things is fun. B, part of my job was cutting things, so I love cutting things. Prep work is always my favorite. And I tested it with, like, one of just the... Actually, I think it was one of her right here.
Oh, spoilers.
Yeah, I cut one of the ones I wasn't as interested in just to see how it worked, and it worked really, really well, so I went, oh, fuck it. Very excited Valentine may be me home if I ever get back. We'll see. Finally, reason to not hate this holiday. It's for us. We're all in love with each other. It's buddy times. As buddy times, and we're going to support each other. It's gonna be fun. When's that bitch this year? On Tuesday. So maybe like on the 11th or the 18th, depending how I'm feeling, we'll have like a Valentine themed Skullurday. And it'll all be love and junk. And by that, it'll probably just be a ton of shit that's hyper fixated on, and we'll just share it with each other and it'll be special. So by saying that, it'll just be a Skullurday. But everything will have like badly cut out PNGs of hearts and shit. So Skullurday, yeah. Same thing. Everyone just getting tax stuff. Oh. Heart flavored Skullurday. Fuck yeah. Everyone gets a weird one to use knives. I don't know. Everyone is so afraid when it comes to something. Done that yet, and it's been years. Talking about Jason Todd and husband being bros and confusing Bruce. Fuck yeah, we will. Jason Todd and husband celebrating a Valentine together, just like clinking beer glasses and hanging out. Yes. With 100% actual heart. Ugh! 100%! Well, I guess it makes more sense if I actually put my arm the right way. With a heart! Skullurday, where we love husband, and also I'll talk about my arrowhead cannons for the Bat Fam. Fuck yeah, you will, Ray! We might just make it like a full talking stream and just go nuts. We'll see whenever we get there. File my own taxes at the tender age of almost 30 because my parents won't do it for me this year. Oh, boo! How dare they? God, I can't wait. The main part of my fuck me, Jason Todd helmet. I'm trying to mix Todd and helmet together. I'm skipping ahead in my words already. The front and the main part of the helmet finished printing sometime either last night or this morning. And, Jason Hot. And the back part of the helmet is printing right now, which I'm hoping. Jason Hot Todd. I'm hoping that it'll be done tomorrow afternoon or tomorrow evening. And then I'll be able to see if they fit together well and just like see. We'll see how it all works together. In a fight to the death with my internet. Good fucking luck surviving, JJ. That's usually a losing battle, but we believe in you. Move out, and it's like they suddenly think I'm an adult or something. Ew! Rebel, no! Adult, ew. Just legally change his name to this just to fuck with Bruce. Just to call by his full name. I caught one of the messages while I was changing some info. What a great start for Toxic 69 in here. Yeah, it's only regulars to the chat that can post links. Sorry about that. But welcome to the void. Hello. Yeah, I saw while I was changing things around, I saw that Marty finished the Modern Warfare 2 video. And then Marty gets it. Marty's on board. I still have to finish it. Got like an hour and a half left, something like that. And I still I need to get through it. I'll try to do it tomorrow morning. All I do is I sit on my fucking tailbone anyway. Hey, Shaggy! Dragging other people into my ships. I mean, what did I do with Skullurday? But like, force people to participate in my insanity. Shukaru. I should have known better! Force, yeah, sure. Every time! Both! You need to memorize the link. I do need to. One of these days I'll see it and I'll go, I know what's happening here. That and the police enigma one. Yeah, but that only surprised me the first time. Now I just look at it and I go, suck that dick, let's go! I'll get flustered. Because I've already been surprised with it once, so instead I'll just stare at it for 3 hours on stream and I'll say nothing. Hide the link in a bit.ly.
Suck my dick, Batman.
Suck my dick, Batman. Suck my fucking dick, Batman. I have a funny YouTube video. Can I please post it? You're brand new to chat, and I'm sure it's funny, but I'm gonna give that a tentative no for a moment until we get to know you a bit better. Because also, if I click on it, it pops up on my screen, so I can't even check it to be sure. Wake up! I don't like this! Chrissy, wake up! Hey, hello? Choker, he's the only straight. Oh, Trans Sunshine, we have. What was that? How long was our ABO DCEU? How long did that go? It was like 2 to 3 hours. Ugh! I love his little fucking, like, just woke up sex curls. They're so cute. Me smashing my controller in pieces. I don't know if I'd personally find that funny. But if anyone wants to click it, I'm sure they can ask you in, like, whispers or DMs, and you can hand it to them that way. There's always that sharing. It's just like, it did just link the article. Here, let me fix it for you. There you go. There. Here's the image. At least 2.5 hours. Okay. You're welcome, Alexa.
Oh, no, he's hot!
Projected my hate of Joker for what he did to Harley. Yeah, that's fair. That's understandable. Ah. Oh, it's just the OBS. We get both. Joker just wants Batman to fuck him, and it will never happen because they're both Omegas. Only everyone thinks Batman's an Alpha. How much is your PC? Be fucked if I know. Mechanical inflation has probably driven it up. In the, like, below the Twitch, there is, there should be a section where it mentions our computer pieces, and mine should be in there. I've got everything listed. You can look it up, but I also built my computer at, like, the end of 2019, so, and the only thing I've done since then is add, like, a couple RAMs, like, RAM cards, so it's relatively still the same. So, whatever's in there, price it out, and you'd have it, but it was, at the time, over 2 grand? I think. Couldn't be entirely sure, but like 3 whole rams. JJ, please, I have 4 whole rams. I also don't think you can buy some of the components anymore, which is why looking up the price of it would be difficult, and a lot of things have changed a lot since I bought the pieces for this computer. But I am proud that I put it together myself. I built this computer. I'm a good boy who can follow instructions. Superman and Alpha and Omega. I feel like Superman would have been an alpha on his planet, but I also feel that Superman's like a beta. But then again, I don't super like Superman. So for me, he's a beta because I just don't want him to exist. What have you got now? Oh, slow-mo apple chewing? Where the fuck you find this, Alexo? Let's put that down there. Is a distraction. Ordered my GPU today. Ah! JJ, you found one? The whole screen with gifts. I'm working on it. Look at that boy eating an apple. Look at this fucking queer. We love him. After Fish stabbed his hand. Also, the audacity to put the slice of apple like horizontal to your mouth, or I guess width. To put the horizontal slice of apple in your horizontal mouth. Damn. Also, I guess Ed here isn't a gif, so oh, he's moving. There we go. Wonder Woman's an alpha. Together, Trinity cover the whole range. Yes, I agree with that now. That's perfect. It's how it comes off the knife. Can't stick the knife in your mouth. If you're a fucking coward, you can't. I eat shit off the blade all the time. You just have to go in the right direction so that you don't cut your tongue. It's cooler. That's also like every time I have steak or any sort of meat where I have a steak knife, I will lick the knife to get the flavor off. You just have to make sure that if you have the blade and you can see that this is the actual blade end, you just have to lick up in this diagonal direction. And I'm not condoning this, but I'm telling you what I do because I'm a danger to myself and society. But you will lick it diagonally towards the blade so that you aren't pressing it to any cutting surface or going in any direction. Like, if you went straight up, you are begging to slice your tongue open. You go up and diagonal because it's the safer way to do something cool and looks badass, and people will think it's hot as hell because you're willing to put your mouth in danger. So, like the apple slice and having it on the blade, you can easily grab it and just pull it diagonally off the tip of the blade. And then it's fine. Which I understand. On the show, they couldn't really do that because Robin Lord Taylor already went to the ER during filming one time because of like a prop malfunction or something, and he got glass in his hand and they had to go fix him up. And there's that really sassy picture of him in full Oswald get up being like in the chair. Awesome. Free tongue piercing with every bad decision. Not just a piercing. You can have some cool tongue stitches, which might be free depending on the healthcare in your area, but probably not. This is what I think of Dennis the Menace. I've never seen Dennis the Menace. Oversized knives that were custom made and sharpen them. My friends and their partners come over. Of course, you gotta assert dominance. Show them that you mean business. I need to shut. It's just so fast. My loves, together. It's like, wow, you're so dangerous, eating the apple off that blade. And Oswald's so smug about it. Everyone's about to die. Cat on my lap. This is the end for me, Fister. No! Christopher Lloyd is a greasy, greasy man. So, like, every third role Christopher Lloyd has ever forgotten. And it's a watching gay. Yeah, it's, pop him up a little bigger. I have a fancy dagger that's great for licking. Truly peak aesthetic. One of his three roles. This is every third role. Also, it's a bad man doing bad things. Oh, ew. Ew. Fuck off with a good Oswald. No. Oh, and Marty, I see the DM you're sending me. You know, Richie's uncontrollable. So, in about 17 years, we'll get the specs for his computer that he had then, and we won't have the ones he has currently. So it's okay. Just don't bother. Nothing will come from it. But thank you. Scientist and granddad, the greasy man. Okay. Those are the other two roles of the three. Okay. Yeah. Now I gotcha. Now I'm understanding your wording. Like, ew, with a happy face. I don't like good boy Oswald. He's so disappointing. He's fun for the story. He's fun to observe briefly. But I think he's disgusting. End up wondering why you tried. Then the twister pulls you up with it. Because somehow it's become tangible. I want to wreck up, but like not even in a fun way. I need to make Ed smaller, like he's in the background watching Oswald in the foreground. I'm a director. Why does this man have so many weird villains? Oh my, I already forget most of them. All I know is that I want the Eraser Man to be in, like, a popular Batman movie. I want him to be real again. But he comes clean and then immediately gets a foot in the door of doing something else or ulterior. Well, like, good boy Oswald was fine. But, like, he was fun for the plot, he was fun for the moment. And I just like him fucking snapping. And I don't condone even vague harm to animals. But it's the fact that the first thing he did was have the potential death of an animal on his mind just to test a theory. It's so Oswald. And it's like, because that was Grace's dog. I'm assuming that's why he didn't care for it at all. It was either Grace's dog or maybe like Charles's, Sasha's. It was some part of the family. Because I feel if that dog belonged to his dad specifically, he wouldn't have tried it. But because I imagine the dog was either belonging to the family or belonging to Grace, it was like, casualty. Who cares? Is what he'd do. When he snapped, I was like, come on, babe. Yes. Fucking get her. So then it just made it like quadruple funny when he got Edward the dog. The dog who meant so much to him. That Edward, whenever like something happened to Edward or Edward went missing, Oswald was like crying. But he's like, they took my dog, and the voice breaks. It's like, bitch, that was his Edward. Belonged to his dad, he probably would have gravitated to it, and Grace would have likely kicked the dog out. Yeah, so I have to imagine that it's like the Grace side of the family. RLT voice breaks. Oh! Fucking I Did It For Love? The voice break in I Did It For Love? Oh my god! The emotion? I'm ready to cry when he does that. That's my vicious little spitty boy. I love it. He gets mad and he just spits everywhere and it's like, bitch, that's real. Let's go. Lane's messaging me. I have to answer this. I have to answer this because Lane is important. He's not been feeling good. So I want to check up on him. Go send Lane our blessings. Will do! It's the nose, not real. JJ, that is, like, legitimately one of the most incredible moments I've ever had about Gotham with this chat. Is you in the prosthetic nose. Hi. Fucking Oswald with the door. Hi. Hello. Hi. Hi. Just Ed laughing. Hi! More than likely, Sugar, we'll see you next time. You and all them meetings, you're so business. It's not the it's definitely not the Riddler. That is the mostly Ed amalgamation. These Pokemans and we got them 1% of nearly dead Fister. No, I'm gonna just change this. There we go. I'm gonna keep no backseating on because I think that's funny in the tags. Don't backseat my Gotham. God damn it. There you go. I need to think of something funny to be my final words. Shit. I don't know. How about something 69420? Ah, classic Fister. Haha. Backseat a lot. It's okay when you do it, Alexa. I can allow it. No backseating. These are our headcanons, exactly. No strangers are allowed to backseat. This is a void space only for this shit. Brad. I love my boyo. Telling us I feel better, bitch, parentheses, affectionate. So excited to see Oswald eating. Well, I mean, for all the time he was healing him and Oswald was pushing away water glasses and all that, he's just happy to see him cared for. No canon in this stream. Fuck no, the canon is not the best. We build off of canon and make it better. Anybody remember the episode it is when Corey and Ben have that scene that should have won awards when Ed revealed himself to Jim? Me? Yeah. Whenever he's got the cuckoo clock and it gets Jim to sit on the rigged chair. Cannot see canon. Mm-mm. Can't see. I can't see your canon. It's not real. Season 2, episode 17, I think. Let's see. I could go to Gotham. I can also just go to Goog. Spoilers, maybe. I don't know. His father's death. Yeah. That's this one. Rotten Tomatoes. Oh, the good jacket. Oh yeah, Into the Woods is where Ed finds Oswald later and brings him back to life. Spoiler Ted is really. Oh, JJ. 16. Oh my god. Guess it'd help if I didn't shrink it, huh? Similar. Yes, one of these. Sixteen is Ed captures Jim. 17, Jim gets away. People see a character and the character will say, I love this man. And the character is a man. They'll say they're straight. The straights need to be fixed. We need to fix their brains, because the streets are not okay. I'm lost in the wiki. Damn it, Alexa! What is it? It is episode 17. I said Alexa was right in 17. But I also remember going through like 15, 16, 17, and 18 very heavily, semi-recently, so they're all blended into one thing. It's like, yeah, that sounds right. What in my porn stash can I open? How many? Pinterest and shit. Oh my god, the image is big now. The image is so big. I could fix him, yeah? Well, I could accept him as he is. You don't like the murder? Grow up. The atrocities are part of him, and I've decided they're funny. My gaze. Message me, yikes. Tracer's apparently straight, even though it's the exact opposite in canon. Some people are just so fucking mad about nothing. Ah! Like, you can see how much ass he has, even in bad lighting. Because it still catches it. The set was beautifully lit! I like how the only light in Ed's apartment is over the kitchen and over in this one table. Don't really separate the episodes. Yeah! I can make him worse! Ugh! I mean, that's what Ed wanted. Ed wanted to be made worse. Because he wanted Oswald's tutelage. So, I mean, that's not wrong. For tone, not for visibility. Ew. It's fucking little kitchen. He is the asshole with the pans hanging up on, like, the ceiling rack. And his fucking, like, little snack fridge. Like, what looks like a vending machine kind of fridge is behind Jim. Envy's butcher bot counter. Ugh. I love this bitch in here. So wibbly wobbly. Those are they are heat lamps, because look at the fucking color of them. Her snaps us a question whether being a cop and killing people makes Jim sane or insane. The fucking argument of Jim being like, he's a psychopath, and Ed just turning around being like, psychopath seems a strong word. I mean, he's like, oh, when other people kill people, it's like horrendous and psychopathic, but when you do it, it's totally fine. Which I think is a very fun parallel to every other conversation Oswald has with Jim. Where Jim's like, I'm not a dirty cop. And Oswald goes, except for all the times when you are. Okay, bitch. Other villains are like, at least we're honest about who we are. You're just an asshole, Jim Gordon. Jim is using his little brain through the whole scene, and I was proud of him. That's the problem with it, though. Jim is, like, stupid good at solving puzzles. And I'm sure it's mostly because the plot wants slash needs him to be. Like, he's a detective, and he was in the army. So he's got, like, a puzzle solver's brain. But, I mean, the plot makes Jim as smart as he is. He figures out shit real convenient, like... Slim Jim, am I the problem? Am I one of the dirty cops, Jim? Eh. And I love when the cuckoo happens and Ed's little, like, looking back at the clock and the big smile. Like, damn. You really are like this, you asshole. I love you. Idiots are really good at one thing are my favorite trope. I really like fic where Oswald sees Jim is like, ooh, I can make him worse and then does. Honestly, though, with the amount of people who have had bad intentions and wanted to make Jim worse, they made him worse. In the series, like, it happened with almost no fight, other than Jim going like, but I'm a good cop, and they're like, but Jim. this would be easier. And Jim goes, oh shit, yeah, you right. And then is then worse, so you know? Like, the Gobblepot shippers? Absolute. Like, two legs to stand on. They get it. They know. It works. I feel like Harvey would accept the fact that they're all dirty cops, but also I haven't watched Mrs. Show, so I'm picking up vibes from y'all. Oh, absolutely. Harvey's like, oh, I know they're dirty cops, and I know I'm lazy as fuck. It doesn't matter. And the only reason he becomes a better person, like Harvey, is because of Jim. And then Jim goes buck wild and does whatever the fuck Jim wants. But Harvey legitimately becomes a better person. Jim's moral compass isn't a magnet factory. Correct. Harvey steers a judgmental gay. Ooh, yeah, he do. Harvey, my little bisexual, like, crisis man. Well, I guess biromantic is really what I make him, right? Harvey has to call Jim on his bullshit. Oh, does he ever? Lied or told the truth to Barbara in the beginning of the series and entangled somebody thinks is alive. Just tell her or lie who Oswald is to him. Ugh. Jim is so fucking flip-floppy. And I don't appreciate it. Either be bad or be good. Pick a fucking lane. I love his little trap sticking out. What a slut. What else do I have in here? Yeah, see? Same picture. Left when Harvey quit drinking over 32 days. Oh, and he was so proud of himself, too! And I was like, fuck yeah, Harvey! I was also proud of him. Is this one? Oh. I love that. I don't give a single flying fuck what's happening right now, pose. It's so good. How Corey played like season 1 and 2 versus how he's in like 4 and 5. Ugh.
Oh, no, he's
yeah, he is. That. There we go. Look like John Green? I don't know if I know who that is. There's snips I got in my feverish binge. Author of A Fault in Our Stars. Okay, so that's why I don't know it. I do not read romantic things, and I do not watch romantic movies. I know A Fault in Our Stars is also super sad, but I just never got... I never personally understood those sorts of things. I heard people really liked it, though, and that's what matters. Got bullied off of Tumblr? Aw. I mean, before I aw, did he get bullied off Tumblr for a reason, or...? Oh, I want to steal his lunch money. He's the reason you can't edit posts anymore? Was it one of those things where it's like, you get a lot of likes and retumbles on a post and then people like retroactively go back and change it to like a horrible thing or... Percentage chance of Asan is straight? Exactly none. Harassment campaign, like bullying. It was fucking bad. Post of his got hijacked and edited to say some... Okay, so it is that thing. It's just he didn't do it. Somebody else did it. He got bullied because people hated him. They thought it was funny to fuck with him. God damn it, Tumblr. Tumblr is just high school, though. If people decide you are a victim, they will harass you to no fucking end. That's a shame. You know what, Alexo, actually, if I had to guess, that's 89% a straight man. Definitely. That was on Nickelodeon website in your dash. You know, I wouldn't put it past me if there was a Nickelodeon something on there. There might have been. Don't know if it's anything. I know I've got like a website saved somewhere that's essentially just like a whatever pirating site, so you can look at old cartoons that are behind paywalls now. Just saw the orange, okay. People didn't like the type of things he wrote, so they decided to bully him. All rude. They said the percentage. Well. Made this one, would you make JJ? Oh, look at these good times! It's beautiful, JJ! It's 100% fruity, can't tell you what type, but he ain't straight. Oh no, he not. The character ain't straight and the actor ain't straight and God fucking bless. Finally. Top right when he's- yes, that's when he's getting crushed by the car. That's when he's in the press. Strong play on Maroni. Ugh! One of the 18 times he just made up a name and said he was a person. It was glorious. I mean, there's the potential. I don't do any ex-readers because they freak me out. I can't do ex-readers and I can't do fanfics that are told in the eye and like you, me, like you are the person participating. Like kind of narrator. I can't do it. Freaks me out. I hate it. It makes me so uncomfy. It's a werewolf. I'm listening. Dandy's on it. Let's see. I love this coat on him. Same episode, because it's a... Well, same. God, which are the 8 tabs did I open? Same episode! Well, same couple episodes anyway. Lane! Lane, my true love! Lane, hello! Yeah, Lane hadn't messaged me back, so I'm afraid I did not get to tell him your message, Dandy, but now he here! Can I find Bruce at the art auction? The only good video images are YouTube or TikTok. Aww! Baby Bruce going, woo! I love art! Alfred just going, oh, bitch, okay. Meds are wearing off. Ooh! So you're doing good coming back then. That's awesome. They're keeping you, like, overnight because this was a late time slicing, right? Lane did have to have surgery. I didn't want to tell chat Lane had to have surgery. So I unfortunately told you guys that he just wasn't feeling well because I wanted Lane to tell everyone that he's having surgery. Or has had surgery. He's out now. I got a cool picture of the scars. I guess they're not scars yet. I got a cool picture of the wounds. I thought you mentioned it. No, I was gonna let you say that. And, I mean, now you did. But... it's Riddler, Oswald, Jim, and Skulls of Gotham! What are we slicing and dicing? Lane had an appendix attack. He got it snipped out. Baby's got some appendicitis. Who needs that thing anyways? Not a lot of people, apparently. Isn't the appendix that doesn't really do anything for us anymore? Like, it did something back in the day, once upon a time, but now through evolution, like, we don't super need it anymore. Is that the appendix? One of the organs is like that. Yeah, it's just the bacteria. But now we control our own bacteria with, like, vitamins and our diets and everything like that. Back in the days of the heaven in the 70s. Yeah, but I also say yesterday and I mean, like, last week. No sense of time. I'll be like that. You will learn these things about me and trying to tell a story that happened not presently. I'm gonna be lurking till I pass out. Love you too, Lane. Pass out. Get your sleep. Heal. Do good things for you. Everyone dropping all these good gifts. Oh, God. Him, tiny cup. Does this to me a lot, Giphy, where it doesn't load what I'm looking at. Ah! My mother always said a party isn't a party without entertainment. Also, these whores with, like, four bottles of wine on the table, like, what the fuck? These gays been sloshing through the night. This one. Running for mayor! Is it 1987 where their Gotham is? I can't remember and I did the research for it. Yes. Quintessential penguin pick is the running for mayor in the group thing. I really like the pace of this cut. Like, it made sense to have it slower with the actual, like, scene in the show. But just this, how it's playing out now, I don't know, it's very satisfying on my eyeballs. disgusted and friendly at the same time. Bitch me. That's what I aim for. That's what I hope I look like. It's also the great thing is Ed having put the bandages on like this, which I know for certain owies you would, but like how I talk about in season 5 where Oswald busts through in like his little 1920s slip of a pajama. And you see like the black tank top he's wearing underneath. And it's like, if people translate that black tank top to a binder, let's fucking go. I see it. Ed having bandaged Oswald's chest like this, I think also plays very well to the trans Oswald supporters, and I love that. I was going for the year Jason died in the comics. Solidified a year in my head, but I don't know if that's the lore for the Greater Void Gotham. We'll go with it! If it wasn't before, it definitely is now. 1988, let's go! Frozen in time! Look at me slouching. In my chair, just sitting on my tailbone more and more and more. Love how this stream is now. Just look how many shots from Gotham I can fit on my monitor. It could be a lot. City frozen in time, no wonder Voidy set up shop and kidnapped as many feral gremlins as possible. What else is a creature void of human understanding's boundaries? Like, what else is a creature like that gonna do? This stream is sponsored by Gotham. I fucking wish. One day. I'm gonna reach out to Mr. Ben McKenzie himself and be like, look, I know you directed a number of episodes here and I know you're part of the production team. Can I get, like, a sponsor? I know the show's dead and done, but, like, retroactively. If only we could do a Gotham Watch stream, be sponsored by Gotham. Ugh, if only. Best we got is, trying to screen share on Discord. Shows that it's very not dead to us. Found Ed picking a locker, but someone had to privatize the image from the open a new page. Boo! What is that new GCPD show? I don't know. He want that fucking tuna sandwich so bad. What's Voidy to do? Politely ask people, please come hang out. No. Voidy is to plant the seeds. I need to move out of this crime-ridden city in New Jersey right now for no discernible reason into people's heads. That'll get them. Like I said, move out. Move to! God knows what the fuck I'm reading anymore. Won't come out of my mouth, right? Oh. For all of us little gremlins, though, in Voidy's new Gotham, we go, yeah, fuck yeah. And I get an apartment that I can share with, like, 30 people. The rent is dirt cheap. Let's go. Fister, you live! any of the other heroes, say Superman or Flash, try to talk to Bruce into letting them try to bring Gotham into the correct time frame, and Bruce, the only time he ever acknowledges time being frozen, goes off and says that if anyone tries to fix Gotham, he will retire and let Tim take over. He'll make evil Batman happen if you fuck with the city. Yum. I love that he puts that in his fucking corner's notes. Licking a watermelon off and then yum. Phone died while you were lamenting. Oh, the 1%. It's taken too much. Apparently the killer was left-handed. Oswald? Also, let's give it up for fucking Robin Lord Taylor being left-handed and giving some lefty representation. Oh, that's watermelon! That is watermelon. He was doing a stabbing test and is just going ham on watermelons. And it just, like, covers him. Sure, Ed eats people, I guess. Yeah, no, no. He ate the watermelon and licked it off his hand and went, yum. On the charger and catless. Aww. Well, we're happy to see you, Fister, but I'm so sorry for your loss. Oh my god, these fucking queers in the background. I fucking. While the rest of them try to piece shit together. These two are full on boning in front of everyone. Ah, yes, the Scooby Gang! And there it is. Of all the destroyed watermelons. Not my favorite Butch suit. Gigi being like, the fashion catalog for Butch's fashion brings me so much joy. Is that when Fish makes her reappearance? Yeah. Yeah, it is. Because that's when, let's see. Tits. Yeah. That's when this happens. Fish or Ivy showing up? Judging by the nails, Fish. That's Ed's sad face. When Ivy was more of a ditz, I am middle stage Ivy. Cause she was the one taking care of Oswald at the time. I am a grown man crying out loud. Sounds like somebody's hungry. Yeah, Fish was absolutely, like, such a cool character. And they kept forgetting she existed, and then they brought her back in such a weird fucking way. And then Jada was still doing her absolute goddamn, like, damnedest with Fish. And it was working again. And then she just kind of... That's, like, the end of her. She just kind of feels like she just wandered off. Like a child lost in the mall. We're waiting for security to call us about having found fish at, like, H&M underneath a rack of discount sweaters. Well, let's see. If this entire crew is a Scooby gang, you do have 5 members, which is perfect. Let's see. Let me do it this way, because it'll be faster for me. Right, because I was doing the marking system. Fuck off. I keep trying to control Z and it doesn't work every time. Okay, but like... we can all agree on that, right? And it is crapping out again. 160p, it's still buffering! And I bet the GIFs don't help! Abathon, Barbara, Fred, and Daphne. I can see it. And I mean, unfortunately, if that's how they go, I would see Butch as Scooby. Awesome. Cannot see that. Just because of all the time that Oswald and Butch spent together. And then, to be honest, great with traps, but not the smartest. That. Riddler jinkies! All the times Oswald says soinks. I didn't want to make Barb Daphne for just, like, fashion girl. But I'm also thinking of, like, Michelle Geller. Live action Daphne, who was like a martial artist and a badass. And just Barbara as that kind of Daphne has that drive. Only time it connects to Velma and Shaggy is a couple! Big samesies. It's okay. The only reason Velma's not a lesbian in this one is because she's a bisexual man. Seeing the circumstance and the gang split up, Ed and Oswald go off on their own, Butch, Barbara, and Tabitha go off on their- yeah. Who gets captured the most? Like, in this group as they are? I mean, if you go by Gotham, this slut gets captured all the goddamn time. So it feels right to have Oswald be the damsel in most situations. He's just a feral damsel. There's your Daphne. Slick is catching and beaten up, and he looks great doing it, right? Well, it's kind of like... Daphne is the bait, and Daphne gets captured fairly often, although it's also Shaggy and Scooby who have to deal with the bad guys the most. And normally they're not physically caught. But I mean, in the show, they're cornered almost all the time. They just go through some Hanna-Barbera, Benny Hill, door bullshit and escape, which I feel is also very Oswald. May think Barb is Fred because Barb tries to lead. I also thought about that. I just didn't think that Barb was dim-witted enough, like, himbo enough to be Fred. But I also agree that, like, Barb and Tabby could switch roles and it would essentially be the same thing. Velma and Scooby that fight each other for Shaggy's love. Alright, so like this trio is just spot on. But I'll draw through there. If they could switch and they're versatile. They're versatile. They could go either way. It's really depends on the episode. There. Could go either way. It's like we're back at our MS Paint days. I don't have a ton of choice with color options, huh? It's like it's a diamond, right? Oh, that's a bad yellow. Okay, we're gonna go with maroon instead. No one's gonna be able to. Butch survives purely on Deus Ex Machina, like most of the time, like Scooby, yes! Who would be the Scrappy-Doo to this crew? What kind of a Scrappy? To Martine! Violent, tiny little thing. Jim being the Scrappy would be very, very fucking funny. Jim running around this city being like, GCPD power! And everyone's like, shut up! Fuck off! Middle stage Ivy. I think like, middle stage Ivy just did not have the, we'll say, the annoying ferocity. Because Scrappy was, I mean, Scrappy, he was constantly picking fights. Ivy just kind of floated along and existed. It's a red herring if he's not Scrappy. Red herring, yes. Can we potentially accept a little teenager Jonathan Crane as Scrappy-Doo? just kind of pops in every now and then, causes drama, picks a fight, and then just leaves. We don't hear from him again for, like, another season. Who is Zaz? There really aren't enough characters. There's not enough regular characters. This is the Hex Girl! Him and his boyfriend, Headhunter. Two of them are Hex Girls. Can I kill him now? It's very scrappy energy. That's the problem, though, is Zaz mostly listens. Scrappy does whatever the fuck he wants. So, like, Zaz, once he breaks free of Oswald's control and starts working for the Falcones, I think then, absolutely, has very scrappy energy towards the crew. But then he's just obedient for Falcone. Harvey's like great country Scooby with the hat. Let's see. Wendell. Oh, Scooby Dum. Aww. He do be having a nice hat, much like Harvey does. Candy Mint? Fuck you. Let's see. Yabadoo is the white Great Dane. Who's the Isaac nephew? Oh, so Yabadoo is, like, Scooby's brother? Scooby D is a female Great Dane, white fur. What the fuck? Girlfriend of Scooby Doo. Seems like a, it does seem, yeah, because I was about to think that Yabadoo was that little caveman dude who runs around in a bunch of Hanna-Barbera productions. 13 ghosts. But does Scooby have a girlfriend? Because everything, you have to know that everything fucks. Everyone has to know that shit fucks, like, automatically an incident when they were babies. Captain Caveman. That is the man I'm trying to think of. Mayor Fred Jones Sr. Fred's father. You mean Freddie Prince Jr. played Fred Jr. in Scooby-Doo? What the fuck? Mr. E, go fuck yourself! Why was such an elaborate plan? He He's killed by Professor Burholz. The fuck? Branstad was the mayor? Mayor of Coolsville? Oh, voiced by Louis Black. Oh, that's fun. Yeah, so, not a ton of extra characters to draw from. Other than the Scooby Gang itself. Not a lot. Not a lot to really tie things together. As you pull on the bad guys, Jim. Jim Gordon. And someone goes, that's not Jim Gordon, that's, and then they go to grab on the next skin again, and they're like, no, it actually is Jim Gordon. Shit. What do we do now? We've made art today. Come on. Come on. Where's my mouse? There she is. Throw Jim in Blackgate again? Maybe this time he'll stay there. Bruce Wayne, what are you doing here? Bruce Trunk, I love art! Baby Bruce in a full man suit. I think I've been saving them in the wrong spot, goddammit. Oh well, we'll move them later. Hashtag yum. Y'all also get to see my naming conventions. Coming up with shit. Closing with 17 fucking tabs that I've got going. So many beautiful things have happened. It's been a wonderful night. Save on links. No, JJ. I love links. I have no problem with having links. I am very good with linking things. The whole little album. I do want this one though. Would it take to get RLT to join the chat and dream I shall chase? If he wasn't on, like, oh, he's on one of the Law and Orders, maybe it's SVU, but he's on one of the Law and Orders now as a reoccurring character. So, unfortunately, he's busily employed again. So it'll be even harder to try to get him as a guest. But maybe one day, Alexa, we'll work on it. I'm just trying to go to a convention he might be at, but all the Gotham crew now just go to ones over in fucking Europe. Mad. I miss the highlight, like, era of them going to every fucking convention. I'm so mad. Also didn't have an acting license, so... Got Charlie Cox. Oh, you're going for sure to Ohio, JJ? Planning on it. Oh, nice! It's true, right now there is Charlie Cox, and I am very excited about Richard Horvitz. So we're just gonna have to see who else joins in on the fun. Something to see a whole cast. Ugh! I wish and I want! Try not to be surprised when he makes eye contact. I'm sure that happens with a lot of people, both in jest and in earnest, when people only know him from Daredevil. He's got that stare down so good. Fuck. Long enough for them to do a reunion yet. It'd be getting close. I mean, to when it first dropped, yes. To it ending, it would still be a bit of time. Development aired. Okay, yeah. So 2014. So next year is 10 years since it started. But we're still, like, 5 years away from a, from when it ended, and you're more likely to have a reunion when it ends than when it begins, but can't eat this apple for me? I brought a knife for you! A great way to be banned from a convention. David will be 20 soon, yeah. David's, like, a full-grown baby now. I'm from Stardust. Oh my god. Weird little movie. I've seen clips from it though. It's cute. Haven't seen Daredevil with Charlie Cox, at least not yet. It's very good, Marty. If you have time, which you're very busy with many things, if you can ever fit it in, Daredevil is a fun watch. And Charlie Cox is a very, very good actor in general. But he's a very, very good Daredevil. He's the best I've seen yet for it anyway. And he's got, like, one of the best stares. Because they do have him out of his little flashy Matt Murdock red glasses every now and then. But the way Charlie Cox fixates on different points either on the people or around them, you really get a look that he could potentially actually be blind. So, like, you are believing that his Matt Murdock is blind versus something like fucking Ben Affleck's Daredevil, where he just seemed to be like looking down his nose most of the time. But Charlie's like looking at where the sound is coming from, but it doesn't look like he's focusing on the person. It's just very good. Phone's telling me it's past 12:30. Or it is 12:30. It always makes a ding whenever it's half midnight. Copies of the cast is going to things together, BTS. Yeah, his appearance. I never saw that Spider-Man movie. But I got very excited to hear that he was in it. He's just a very good lawyer. I'm excited that Charlie Cox is being used in, like, all of the MCU shit. And people are like, more! And everyone went, fine! Great reflex, sketch a brick. He's just such a damn good lawyer. Ugh. It's just, can't wait for more conventions. And I'm happy to still be able to talk about Gotham and have chat participating, and I love sharing this in general. And I've got like a couple little floating ideas in my head for a few more additions to my Southern story, but like I don't know how many more I'm gonna do, because I'm getting very near a point where I'm getting happy with it, and where I'd be like, yeah, absolutely. Like, come to a point where we can wrap it up, and then the main part will be done, and if I ever do any extras, it'll just be, like, a little for funsy thing. But I really want to put together, like, almost a small book of all these little things together. And I want to, like a children's book ever, like, kind of thing. And I want to do it, like, I basically have a Pinterest kind of thing where, you know, you'd collect all your pictures on Pinterest, and then you'd put together, like, the little Tumblr shot that's always, like, a 2x3 to describe your character. I want to do, like, one of those with the story and get to have, like, essentially a little picture per story, and then just put together this little, like, pamphlet of a book and just have it for me. Did she ever touch on a Zachariah more? I didn't touch a Zachariah really, like, to begin with, let's be honest. I'm throwing things. I'm gonna burn a Zachariah one day. But, like, yeah. I don't know if it's really coming to, like, a full completion, but it's definitely coming to a point where I'd be happy saying that it's done enough. And then if anything else comes into mind, then it's not really... Yeah, it's not losing out on anything. Like, everything is packed together. It makes a little story. It all makes sense. It's all coming together, and it's full of, like, love and little stories. And then if anything else needs to be added to it, then it could just be added. But it won't be added to, like, the little book. It'll just kind of, like, be added in my head. And that'll be fine. It's your rival's name, but it just broke my test file. Yeah, that's fine. Zachariah Zed. We'll just have to know in our hearts is who he is, and that's okay. We'll live with it. We all know. I know who can help write your book. He can draw my pictures! Joel Fry is a cutie patootie, and I hope he's done nothing wrong. Because I like him. I liked him in the Cruella movie, too. He was fun. Gonna tell my brain it's done, so it's more likely to let me read it. It was... That was him! Yeah! He was, and I never remember. Horace the tall, skinny one, and Jasper... is the chub man? Or is it the other way around? I never remember the order of the names. Jasper. Okay. Yeah. Joel Fry played this one. And he did a really sweet job of it. He was like... Both Horace and Jasper were like little emotional turning points. In the movie. It was really cute. I liked it. It was fun. And that's the whole thing. But I also think that, like, fashion in general is really fun. So, like, the whole, like, fashion aspect of Cruella, I loved it. I thought it was a lot of fun. I thought it was super cool. I always, like, I was into it visually. I was watching it so hard. Because, like, design and fashion is super cool, and I want to, like, absorb that as much as possible. And I think it's fun. So that's where I had a good time with Cruella, and some people didn't like it, and that's totally cool. Devil Wears Prada meets Ocean's 11. Yeah. Joel Fry's top shelf makes me smile, right? Zachariah is his government name. He added the Z himself because he thought it made him cool. And that's why we can't call him Zachariah Z, because we're like, no, bro, that's not your fucking name. He's like, yeah, it is. So we gave him his birth name to his grandfather, but we don't call him by that name. Okay. I'm down with that. That makes sense. His child trying to be creative for his amusement. Good times. I guess this is pretty much an end of stream time, right? I mean, we only talked. And I was like, we'll play fusions this time. You gonna drive to Columbus? Sure. Do whatever works for you. Explaining what I find in the stream. Bit of fanfiction of your captain? I just like to imagine him in all sorts of made-up situations. Yeah, I know, Lane and, his man drove to Columbus, and, the girl I stayed with, she drove to Columbus. I can't without it taking a couple days, at least, but, other than that, I'd also drive, but that's not... I have to fly. Had fusions, just not a Pokemon fusion of ideas. Ooh, damn. Paying bridge toll to the troll. Gotta pay like $50 to get off the island. Fuck me. It's supposed to go down soon. In September? Question mark? A little sad we didn't see monstrosities. So much fun. It balances it out. Oh. Next time. We might play it on the weekend. Oh, dearie me. I know I said we might flip back and forth between them. Between, like, Fusion and Overlord. And we played Overlord last weekend. So we might go back to Fusions this weekend. And then... next weekend, we'll go back to Overlord again. And we'll just flip-flop and we'll feel the vibe. We'll see what happens. Yeah. It'd be nice. Wouldn't it be nice if... how many Master Balls we'll find? Hopefully more. I found zero. Oh, JJ, no! And you won the game. Maybe have an affordable... we're fucking open. Especially, like, if it can drop in September, which I know is kind of the rumored time at the moment. Hopefully, if it does happen in September, that would be fantastic, because then Autumn and I are going to the mainland for a convention in October. So then that is, like, half the cost of that right there. Master Balls are good, right? Yes. Right, those are the best Pokeballs you can get in the game. They cannot break open. When you throw a Master Ball, 100% guarantee catch of the thing, no matter what. I mean, as long as it's not a trainer's Pokemon, but if you come across wild Pokemon or a legendary and you throw Master Ball, done. Hopefully the Master Ball trees will show up. I want to find another Master Ball tree. Because that was fucking rad. Goddamn. A bush just growing three fucking Master Balls? What the fuck? Catch the trainers. If I catch the trainer, then all of their Pokemon are automatically mine. Voltorb looks like a Master Ball. Yep. Oh yeah, look at him. No. Squish this up some so everyone can. Yeah. The world of a trainer throws out a Pokemon, you can throw a Master Ball and collect them. It'd be so funny. Although you're also then just like team snag them in a couple different like GameCube Pokemon games.
Bleh.
He has a website since Homestar Runner. Oh, I need to look at that shit again. Have to look at the doubles. Yeah, there is like. Does the one that randomly fuses them, is that one with like the complete sprites, or is that the one where it like slaps the head on the body? Because I know of that one, but I don't know if there's a better one, or if that one was updated to have all of these. Oh, the full sprites. Ooh, interesting. Also, I don't like looking up too many of them. Cause I like the surprise to be for me. So that I can be surprised on stream and it makes it more fun. But. Go there at least once a day just to see what happens. Aw, that's nice though. A little treat just for you. Let everyone have their fun. Yeah, I'm almost gonna be done with the story soon. And if anyone has a cute idea, if anyone has a cute idea for anything, can let me know, because I do wanna write for more of these people, of all of the things, but know, this has also been like a big me thing. Like, I think Ray's the only one who's read any of them. Have you ever looked inside the Pokédex in-game and looked at the sprites? It shows the old ones. No, I haven't. Damn. I love them. Thank you, Ray. I appreciate that. Even set them as the sprites you use. Oh. I know some of the old ones, and that would be. All right, now I've been playing. Damn. I've been playing a different Pokemon ROM, so now I forget what buttons that I've set for everything. Oh my god. What ROM? It's the Rocket Edition one. Edge is having a bad luck one day. Toast burns, drops phone on tail, car is a flat tire. Wakes up. He wakes pissed off. It was just a dream. He's angry for the new day. I do love the Charmander. I think that's so funny. God, remember our super cool boy who was super ultra cool? It'd be someone who gets angry about things that have- Oh, absolutely. Like, Alexa was right. I miss Cool Eddie. Buttle is so cute. Mudgeot. This is Sprite Tab. Oh yeah, look at that! Oh, that's fun. I mean, this is clearly superior. He got into the game, shut up! Gives Ozzel a cold shoulder because he cheated on him in a dream! Oh, Ed is the mad girlfriend. From having a fucking dream. No one here is wrong, everyone is right. No other option. Oh, that's fun. I'll kind of show you what I've been doing. The thing is, in order to do this ROM, you need a download of Pokemon Fire Red 1.0. Some of them right now are at 1.1, and that does not work. You need a 1.0, which apparently, if you look for squirrels, that is a confirmed 1.0 Fire Red ROM. And you can use it on a Pokemon, like, Rocket Edition site. Put the ROM in there, and the website will patch the Rocket Edition onto the ROM. And then once you do that, you can play it. I'm using the VBA. There's another emulator you could use for it as well. I saw you with that whore. Who? What the fuck are you talking about? In my dream, I saw. How dare you? So, in this game, and it's a little blurry because it does not distort or size well. But this whole game, you get to play as a Team Rocket member. And right now, this is my team. And all of these Pokemon I stole from small children and old people. So we got Pikachu. If you really love me, you wouldn't cheat on me, not even in a dream. We got a Pidgeotto. A Mankey. Growlithe. Nidorino. And a Geodude. The perfect game for you, thank you. So this game kind of lets you play both sides. You can either go full Rocket, and when I tell you that as a Rocket member, when you fight trainers, you get almost no money. You get like 50 bucks per person, maybe. So you make no muns. And once you get to a certain point, the game makes being a Team Rocket member or a criminal in general essentially illegal. So depending on your badness level, the Pokemart can tell you to just fuck off and they won't sell you anything. And there are now police officers in towns looking for Rocket members, so I've never walked in front of one yet, but as far as I know, you probably get arrested. And, you can go to the police, which I think that's what they're actual there for, what they're actually there for. I don't think I'll get arrested if I walk in front of them, but they might question me. I don't know. But you can go to the officers and turn in Pokemon that you've stolen. And the higher the level, the more reward you get. And the more reward you get, the better you are in society. And the more good guy you are and are seen as, versus you can go into it hardcore and steal every Pokemon that you get the opportunity for, and basically, like, you get a Pokemon steal count to see how bad you are. And even if I have multiples of Pokemon already, I will steal a Pokemon if I have the opportunity to, which... Let's see for a second. We're healed. How bad could I be? Yeah, the volume on this is stupid low, so you might not hear anything at all. Because I always crank it down. Steal his Pokemon to sell them back. You can do that, although you will be rewarded as a good guy if you sell any of them back, and you will be given good guy points. And I want exactly zero good guy points if I can at all avoid it. I don't want to be a good guy. I don't want to get a single good guy point. I am hoarding all of these Pokemon I'm stealing, and no one can have them back. They are mine, and if I fill up the computer, then I am simply going to release them into the wild. No one gets them back. Of course, poison point. No, Pikachu can die, that's fine. Illegal black market trade? Well, you're selling them to police officers, essentially. So, you are really turning them in, you are just getting a reward in return. So it's not like you're just selling them to any Joe Blow, you're giving them back to the police who are looking for them and want to return them. Zero good guy points, but sir! Police can deal in the black market. Yeah, I know. But right now, although the game talks to you about corrupt police and everything, that's not the frame of it. We all know, but the game isn't framed like that. My mind is spacing. You okay, Alexa? Hey, Kita. So, I've now defeated this child in battle. So, I get the choice. Do I want to steal a Pokemon? Of course I do. And I'm gonna take a Nidorino. Cause fuck this kid. This is gonna seem like a choice because of Gotham, but... Oops. I can also show y'all the method behind the madness in a second. So. That's how, like, that works. Almost fell asleep, oh dandy! Sell him on the black market. Look! I don't know how far this game goes, I'm just on, like, the third mission. But apparently you move up in the ranks. You, can steal from a wider range of people the higher up in the ranks you go. Look, I don't know. I don't know what all this game does, I haven't gotten there yet. It might do cool things like that, I don't know. But these are all the Pokemon that I've stolen so far. So I've just been theming names as I usually do. What region? It's, Fire Red. So it's based in Kanto, but, right now I'm on a mission to give Lieutenant Surge steroids in trade for Johto Pokemon. And I do believe this game includes up to Gen 5? Question mark? Or can include? I'm not sure. But, yeah. Quote unquote steroids. Actual steroids. Inject them in your body to get stronger looking. Steroids. Actual, they are labeled steroids. You get them from a chemist in the Rocket Hideout. If you can sell them eventually, will you tell Chad? I'm curious. Absolutely. I will let you know. I have caught exactly zero Pokemon in balls. These are all stolen. Except for him. He was my Rocket starter. As your starter, you get given a Rattata. And you work up from there. But, everyone else was pilfered. See, that one I named for Munson. Of course, the most famous Spearow ever. Take him roids now. Well, I have beaten up so many kids. I've beaten up, like, 3/4 of these are owned by small children and 1/4 by elderly people. So see, Nidoran male will become Nidoking eventually, so I started naming them after kings. So that is Arthur and King Edward, and there's King Charles. And mine's named Toxicity because he's cool. Oops. And then him. So. It's just a fun little neat, different thing that I've been having a lot of fun with. Playing things differently. This is supposed to take place at the same time, on the same timeline as Fire Red itself. So, like, I think I was saying in stream, you run into Red, who is, like, actually the antagonist of the game. Lance is, like, a... We'll just say, like, a corrupted political figure. The government is bullshit. And you and Team Rocket are looking to dismantle the corrupt establishment and make a little home for yourselves. Benefit. Profit. And there's, like, fun background stuff. There's a real cool connection with characters that I've come across already that it's like, oh wow, that's kind of cool. Yeah, there's just a lot of neat things. Someone put a lot of time and effort and, like, background world building into this. So I was really interested to see what they did and what they have done with the storyline and how things play out. And how you kind of get to cities before Red and Blue do. And things like in Pokemon Red and Blue. Why is it that you get into Cerulean City and the cops are there? Well, there was a Rocket break-in. While in the Rocket Edition, you get to be part of the teams where those things have happened. Like, my character got to interact with one of the characters that did the robbery. So we get all of the background behind that. And it's really neat. I'm having fun with it. She's real fun. It's just like a background. Just like a background game. Oh my god, it Cobblepoot. It is Cobblepoot. And, my display capture. If I go to the other one, it nig more. He's hotter! Nigma's hotter? I agree. Hell yeah. Test is, it's like, what the fuck? Are you actually sure? Because, like, I'm definitely not cured. And they're like, yep, nope, you're fine, you're sane, bye. And he's like, no, excuse you, I'm not fixed yet. And then fucking Oswald roll up in his sick whip and he's like, yep, you know what, actually, bye, I don't need to be fixed. Have a good day. So it's hotter when he's begging for his life. Ugh. I killed 3 people. It was 4. I was also, like, I was writing a different story, one that I kind of abandoned before. I was trying to rewrite it, and I mentioned in the story how he killed 3 people, and then as I was putting it down, I went, he killed 4 people. He's, like, discrediting himself. Watch the Gay Pirate Show. The Gay Pirate Show is very good. The Gay Pirate Show is very good, and season 2 is dropping sometime early to mid this year, so he can't count. You know what, Ray, you fucking got me there. I think it's kind of also a difference of maybe he only counts the ones that he planned for. So I'm wondering if he's not super counting either the farmer because it was an improv kill, or if it was a cadet because it was a frame job and Jim killed him. So. It was an accidental. If you count destroying your witness as accidental. Yeah. Can't watch any romance right now. What if the romance ends excruciatingly sad? Does that change it? Nope. Okay. Well, in due time then. When you're ready, when you want to. That's all up to you. Had heartbroken today. Aw, I'm sorry, Kita. Trying to get my mom to watch a gay pirate show. She wants a fun show. I told her to watch it. The title scares her. Definitely a misleading title that's also very correct. What's the title? What's the title of the gay pirate show? It's Our Flag Means Death. Hope romance ends less sad this season. It can be sad all season until the end. We really do be needing, like, if the first season ends with, like, a sad breakup, it would be great to have the second season end in, like, a soap opera drama-esque, like, twist kind of thing. It'd just be funny for it to hit another, like, tropey thing. Apparently gay ass needed to be approved. My mom watched the first episode and was like, oh, that's fun, while I was laughing my ass off. I guess that's the difference between middle-aged straight woman, whatever the fuck I have going on watching this gay-ass show. Hey, Autobot, fuck you. Yeah. Yeah, to all those things. My parents had fun with the gay pirate show. They watched it with me. Still no monster fucker. One day. Keeping us from the good ones, too. Not even the bad ones. I also don't know why Automod cannot let chat say monster fucker. It doesn't make any sense to me, but we'll just keep letting it go. Bitch. Yeah, people are like, Valentine's Day, they gotta drop something for the gay pirate show, like a peep. People are like, a screenshot Valentine's Day would be amazing. Like, well, do we determine Automod has a daddy kink? I don't remember, to be honest with you. Potentially. We determined a lot of things. A lot of things we do, don't, should, and maybe should not do. Who knows? Daddy fucker, mommy fucker. Wow. It's literally just against monster fuckers, and personally, I find that offensive. Hot period during Spyro where so much was learned about Automa that I do not recall. Truth. Oh. Double daddy. I thought stream was ending earlier. Yeah, I tried. But I mean, I'm here on my own. I'm here on my own, so guess what? No one's here to actually stop me. I'm under my own control, and that, everyone knows what Bad News Bears that is. Daddy moment in season 2. Oh, we can hope. The daddy moment was, improvised. So we can only dream and hope that we get another very similar daddy moment somehow that acts naturally so it doesn't feel like a forced thing. But, one way to find out, and that's by watching it whenever it drops. I'm guessing it'll be this spring. That would explain that, yeah. Con O'Neill is not much of an improv man. And, he is working with a lot of people who are pretty damn good at improv. So apparently in that scene, he panicked and started doing the ooh daddy thing, and it fucking stayed. Chernobyl and Con O'Neill is in it. Yeah! This is how he haunts him.
Stupid fucking Steve Bonnet.
Oh, I love Lucius and Black Pete looking between each other whenever the ooh daddies happen. They're just like, okay. Suck my dick, Batman. Suck my fucking dick, Batman. Anyway, I should try to end stream. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Con O'Neill is incredible. So that was Pokemon Fusion. I hope you all enjoyed. Don't you have work tomorrow? Yes, but later. I don't have to worry about waking up early. Suck my fucking dick.
Has anyone ever told you you have stunning cheekbones?
Thanks, baby. Nice tats. Thank you, I've got a lot of them. I say just showing my arms, but then there's like neck and shoulders and ribs and thighs and calves and shins and everything else, so. Yeah. Ribs! Spams! Fuck! Domain under the chair thing? I will do the damn chair thing. Was that painful? I'm sure it was supposed to be, yeah. Most people, apparently,
why must you fail me so often?
Don't like getting shins done. But I am very good at getting, tattooed on my bones. That's okay, we got you, Kira. And, actually getting my shins done was, like the third easiest tattoo I've ever gotten. I had no problems at all.
Got to be the best part I've ever seen.
So it would seem. Yeah, I had a great time with my shins. We only did like a couple hours on each, and let me not do the chair thing. But let me see how much I can get my leggy into frame on my spin chair. I could push my chair out at all, and I haven't. So that's gonna make it more awkward. Skulls is a pain, baby, that explains everything. I fucking... Yeah, you can kind of mostly see them. I can't bend my leg like that. Fucking light, you can't see shit. No, I can't do it. Fucking headphones and swirly chair and lights, everything else. No feet on stream. I don't mean they're covered. I've got little fucking foot condoms on, so you know. Ha! Eh, you can mostly see it. There you go. Without me doing the chair thing. Rule number one of stream. Uh-oh! Foot condoms, hate that. We did do the Spider-Man feet pics and we showed them on stream. Someone did pay for them, so we have already sold feet on stream. We are accomplished. Stealing foot condoms, go ahead, do it. I encourage it. It will make people uncomfortable. A graceful streamer posture, you know. Real good at that. So, yeah. That was a stream. We certainly didn't play any games, but we talked a whole heck of a lot, and I think we've grown as people. Whether we grew up or down, I'm not sure. But we certainly have grown. I love making people uncomfy. If you want to make people mad and confused, Kita, just like quadruple down on the statement that whatever you don't chew is a drink. People will go nuts. Either people will see the light in the insanity and they'll go, you know what? And some people will go, no, absolutely fucking not. And they'll fight you on it, and you just stand back and let it happen. It's really funny. Sound like a youth pastor for a minute. I'd be a cool as shit youth pastor. I'm like, if y'all kids are gonna fucking do some weeds, just do it behind the fucking shed downwind. Because if I smell it, I'm gonna get a headache. Yeah, if no chew, it drink. Pudding is a drink. Spaghetti is a drink. If you cut up your pizza and just swallow the piece whole, pizza is a drink. It fucks people up. It's really funny. Mashed potatoes are a drink. Grits are a drink. Bread can be... bread's a very dry drink, but bread can be a drink. Youth pastor skulls, believe or don't care. Let's go kayaking. Me. That is, yeah, like quintessentially me. Got injured jaw like a snake. Everything is drinks. Cotton candy is a gas. Yes, we did talk about that. I still like for period, you say your uterus breaks, cracks, or anything along those lines. Ugh. I'll do, my uterus is broken. My uterus is cracked. I'll also do, my uterus has fallen out. There's a lot of, like, shedding is another one. My dick fell off! A lot of fun things like that. I love words. Steak can be a drink. Look, steak can be a drink, and I've drank steak many times. Good night, Kita. And also, good night to you, chat, as we try to sum up for the third time. Don't know what's happening next week. We'll have to see how everyone feels. We might try again. Skulls won't drink liquid, but we'll drink steak. You fucking know it, Dandy. We'll see how everyone's feeling. Yeah, we might try to do extraction next week, because we were going to try it, well, today. That didn't happen. To be honest, I don't super know. Some Rainbow Six game, and I think Richie said it had something to do with aliens. I don't know, but it was on Game Pass. So something. So that'll be next week. Honestly, since we kind of mentioned it tonight, I would love if we could get in, like, a Gartic phone or something soon. Another little artsy-fartsy doodle game, because they make me feel better. Would be nice. This weekend, we'll try to do some Infinite Fusion. We'll see how well we stick to that, but we need more. G-Reg. And yeah, we'll figure out shit as we get there. So. I love you, chat. Have a great day. Have a great afternoon. Have a great evening. Have a great time. Whatever time zone applies to you, do that as best you can. Take care of yourselves as best you can. And I'm going to send out those Valentines tomorrow afternoon. So hopefully, maybe people won't get them on Valentine's, depending, because some of the states, I find mail usually takes a couple weeks. Whenever you guys do get them, let me know in chat. Because then if anyone doesn't get theirs, it would be nice just to know roundabout times when it's happening for everyone. So hopefully for the Americans, it'll be there in the next like couple weeks. And hopefully Canadians, it should be there within the week. And everyone outside of that, hopefully it arrives at all. But we're damn well going to try. So, yeah. I guess that's all the news. Yeah. So. I have to say in chat or DM you when I get it. Perfect! That'd be excellent, Ray. So. Again. Love you guys. Have a good time zone that applies to you. We will see you on Skullurday, and if we don't, I will see you next week. I'll let you know I'm not working this Saturday, so it'll be the usual semi-earlier Skullurday time. And, yeah. That's everything. Goodbye. Good night. We love you.